Well, overall, our progress has been very good this preseason. At first, it started with our players reporting in excellent shape. We had a lot of our players here this summer working with our strength and conditioning coach, John Sauer, and I felt very comfortable about the condition in which they reported. And we have been, so far as practicing in preseason, even though it's tough and all that stuff, we've been very consistent about the way we practice. We've come out there and worked hard, and I think that's a great indicator of the senior leadership that we have on this team. Offensively, I feel like we have made a lot of progress from where we were in the spring. I was not particularly pleased with some of our execution in spring practice, but I think we've taken off from where we left off and have really, really improved, have gotten more consistent offensively, and are not beating ourselves right now. You talk about our offense, I feel like you got to start talking about our offensive line first, because first we've got good experience there, we've got good leadership there, and we've got some very good players there. In fact, this may be as athletic or as good a conditioned offensive line as we've had in some time. You know, with Mike Salazar providing great leadership, Trevor Springman having a tremendous preseason, James Johnson, Matt Crisafi, Robbie Gambito. These guys work well together. As long as we can stay healthy and work together and be cohesive as a group, I feel like it's going to be a fine offensive line. And basically, that's going to have to be the strong part of our offense. Well, at the running back position, the first thing you look at, there's no John Grimes out there. Certainly, we've depended on him for the last 4 years. It's a different makeup, but we're not going to have just one back playing all the time like we did with John. We'll be rotating backs in there, and I've been very pleased. Coach Barkley, who came in this year, is working with them and doing a great job. Altoya Jones, Keith McBride, Abdul Sabor, Darnell Laws. We've got a number of guys in there that have practiced well, have done well, but again, I think we'll probably be alternating our backs in there. Well, losing Alex Gottlieb at tight end, put us in a little bit of a bind, but Nolan Kearney, it was his backup, and he stepped up and had a fine preseason, doing well. Bo Rebel is moving in there too. So, we've got some good guys in there. Our tight end position has been solid. The one group that I've probably been as pleased with as anything, especially on offense, has been the improved play at wide receiver. Ryan Moody has come back in great shape, has stayed injury free, and is playing the level that we feel like he's capable. And then Trey McBride, who played last year as a true freshman, certainly has improved a great deal. So I'm very encouraged by the play of those two, and I feel like we also have some depth behind them. Well, at quarterback, we've had great competition. These guys have worked extremely hard. Mike Graham, Brent Capriol, Ortiz have all competed, all done very well, and they've all raised their level of performance. Well, defensively, the first thing you look at the overall team speed, and I feel like we have very good team speed there. The thing that we're working on very much defensively is for the entire unit to be cohesive, to play together, to understand each and every person's responsibility. We've got Coach Tom Clark is new on our staff in the secondary, and he's helped us a lot. And I really feel like as a group, we're very athletic and we're playing hard. Mm-hmm. On our defensive line, we're certainly encouraged by Brian Stinney being in there. He missed spring practice, but he looks good in the preseason. George Berhalter is one we're certainly counting on inside. Nick Zaremba, Jasper Coleman, Steve Sennett. We've got some solid players in there that maybe don't have as much game experience as we'd like. Some of them have played. But, when we've had our best defenses here is when we've had outstanding play out of our defensive front, and that's what we're hoping for. At linebacker, we were hit a blow with the injury to Dante Cook. We're really not sure how long he'll be out, but certainly he'll be out first few games anyway. And that set us back a little bit. But Jabril Mines is one of our captains and doing a great job. Eric Green has moved back in there and played very well. And Luke Rhodes, a redshirt freshman, has been a not a surprise, but very pleasant to see him jump in there and handle the linebacker position too. Yeah, in the secondary, we've got probably more depth than we've had before. You got B.W. Webb at one of the corners. You got Brian Thompson at the strong safety. Jerome Copeland at the other safety. And we're still battling the other corners and some other guys. But I think in the secondary, we we're playing well. We've got some depth, and I've been very encouraged by their overall play.
Well, you know, on special teams, it's always important. You know, you never forget about your kickers, and it comes down to it.
And punting-wise, Drake Kuhn has certainly done fine there, and John Carpenter has improved a great deal from the spring. So it's still up in the air as to which direction we'll go with punting. But, you know, we got Andy Topping as our deep snapper, which is something you're always looking forward looking at, that's important, too.
Well, you know, and of course, as I mentioned, with Drake handling punting, or maybe handling punting, he certainly will handle our placements, and he has been extremely consistent in preseason. We put him in a number of tough situations, and he's come through, and he's got game experience. So,
well, you know, so far as return game, you know, you've got a guy like B.W. Webb. You want to get the ball in his hands as many times as you can, and, you know, you can't do that much when he's playing corner. So we'll have him returning punts, and we'll also put him back on kickoff returns, and he'll alternate with some of the other guys with that. But we want to get the ball in BW's hands as often as we can.
You know, traditionally we don't play many freshmen, and I'm really not sure if we'll play any this year, but it's no indication about what kind of level of talent we have. I feel like we got a number of very, very good players there. Tyler Clater, a defensive tackle, may get some action. Kevin Hart, a wide receiver, has really jumped in there and played very well. And we've got several other guys that could, but it's still kind of early to see whether or not we'll commit to play some freshmen yet.
Well, you know, as we get to, you know, we had a scrimmage yesterday, and we're now about 10 days to opening, and at this point in time, you want to come back and double-check yourself. There's still a few positions that are up for grabs, but we want our players to get their legs back, we want them to focus, and we want them to continue to improve and not to be complacent, and from what I've seen with our players, I'm sure that's going to happen.